Hey guys, Michael again from Core Evolution. I'm gonna bring you another workout that you can do at home with just a set of dumbbells. Today I got Gallo and I got Gina helping me out, okay? We're gonna go through three different circuits, 4 to 5 exercises each circuit. Each exercise is gonna be about 30 seconds long, and they're gonna demonstrate for you. We're gonna have some modifications. If you have any questions, please feel free to message us on Instagram. Go ahead and shoot us your questions. We'll get back to you. If you have any questions regarding the workout, classes, or personal training once all this corona epidemic is done, let us know and we'll get back to you, okay? So we're gonna start off first with warm up as always. And our basic warm up that we're gonna start with is our jogging in place first. So let's start jogging in place, let's go. And we're gonna go about 30 seconds for about 4 to 5 different exercises just to warm it up. It's always important to warm up, guys. So always do a little bit of active warm up just to get the blood flowing, just to get the the joints looped up and stuff, the mobility going. And we'll go jumping jacks now. Go. And again, if you have any questions about classes, right now with the gym being temporarily closed because of the coronavirus, we're trying to offer these workouts for you guys that you can do at home with very minimal equipment. If you have any suggestions for some workouts, whether it's upper body or lower body, full body, abs, core, whatever you want, shoot us a message and we'll get back to you. We'll set up a workout specifically for that. We'll go ahead and post it and upload it so you guys can go ahead and follow along. And let's go high knees now. Let's go high knees. And for something like this, if it's too tough for you guys to stay on your toes and jogging in place, obviously she's gonna modify it here, so she'll slow it down. As long as we get the knees up to the belly button, that's all we're looking for. So whether we're jogging, staying high on the toes, or just walking, either one doesn't matter, get those knees up to the belly button. A few more seconds. And if you have to slow down, if you have to stop, go ahead and stop, catch your breath, and get back going. And last one, butt kickers. So again, same thing here. We can start off on the toes at a jogging pace. We have to slow down, we slow down, but again, get those heels up to the butt. Ten more seconds. And let's go with some air squats now. Let's go with some body weight squats. So nice and easy, down and up, let's go. And again, like we've always talked about before, when it comes to the squats, whether it's with body weight, barbells, dumbbells, bands, whatever it is, always important that wherever our toes are pointing, that's where our knees go. So if our toes are pointed out, our knees go out. If our toes are straight, our knees go straight. Always important to make sure that wherever the toes go, that's where the knees go. We inhale on the way down, exhale as we come up. And let's go with some walkouts now. No push-ups, just walk it out, walk it back in. Just gonna walk it out into a push-up position and then walk it back up. You can keep your legs straight, you can bend your knees, either one, doesn't matter. Just walk it out into a good push-up position. Do not let your hips drop down. Make sure when you walk out that your hips are tucked under, nice and solid. Your core is nice and tight. And then we walk it back up. Four more seconds. And let's go into that push-up position now. So we're gonna stay in the push-up position. We're gonna go with some push-ups. So again, I'm gonna have Gina demonstrate on the knees. Knees for me, go on the toes. We got push-ups now, ready? Go. So again, whether you're doing them on your knees or on your toes, we wanna make sure our core is tight. Gallo's got a nice straight back. Gina's back is nice and straight. That means your core is tight. Hands are down here by our shoulders and not up here past our head, really important. I saw a lot of people doing those push-up challenges going on right now. And a lot of bad form on those push-ups. Their push-ups are up here and their butts up here. Back is nice and flat. Hands down here by the shoulders, down and up. A few more seconds. And time. Okay, we're gonna get 30 seconds break here. So if you guys got some water, get some water. If you guys get some water, if you have your water, get your water out, really important. And then we're gonna go ahead and get into our circuits. Always important, guys, get your water, get your water. So, and if you don't have dumbbells at home, there's other stuff that you can use. We talked about other in other videos. water bottles, liter water bottles, gallon water bottles, or gallons of water. You go to Home Depot and purchase some stuff. There's stuff that you can be creative with, but if you have dumbbells, even better. So first exercise we're gonna do, we're gonna go with four different exercises. Start off first with our dumbbells on our shoulders, and we're gonna go with just our squats again, but with the dumbbells up here. We can hold them up here, or we can rest them on our shoulders, either one, but we wanna drop it down, try to get the knees to the elbows, and back up. So here we go, so pick the dumbbells up, and squats. Ready, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Good, guys. Inhale on the way down, exhale as we come up. And again, watching the knees, watching the toes. Make sure everything goes down. Good. 10 more seconds. Five, four, three, two, one. Let's set them down. We're gonna go on to push-up position, so we'll do push-ups again. And ready? 3, 2, 1, and go. Again, backs are nice and straight, core is tight, hips are tucked under. Inhale on the way down, exhale as we come up. 10 seconds. Good, guys. A few more seconds. And time, come on back to our feet. We're gonna pick our dumbbells up, we're gonna hold them down here by our side, we're gonna go alternating reverse lunges. Just hold the dumbbells down by our side. So here we go, ready, 3, 2, 1, and let's go. And for this exercise, because we are doing both legs, I kind of raised it up to 45 seconds. The first two exercises were 30 seconds. This one will be 45 seconds. And the next exercise we'll do will be 30 seconds. So we'll drop it back down. As they step back, they have good balance. The core is tight again. Dumbbells are just hanging down. And we've talked about it before when it comes to lunges. We're a big fan of doing the reverse lunges here. This way it ensures that our knees stay over our heels as much as possible and they don't come forward and put more pressure on those knees. Good. We'll get a little cardio in, so set the dumbbells down. We're going to mountain climbers or floor sprints. So here we go, mountain climbers, floor sprints, 30 seconds, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Good. And again, important with these two, hands are under the shoulders, they're not up here. Backs are nice and flat. And they're bringing the knees up into the stomach and the chest. They're not just driving them down, they're bringing the knees and up into the chest and up into the stomach area. 10 seconds. And again, if you're doing these and you have to stop, stop for a second, catch your breath, and get right back to it. 4 seconds. And time, okay? All right, so now, gonna get a 1 minute break. So go get some water, get some water if you need to. All right, so now we're gonna do a few things. And one thing when it comes to these circuits that we're gonna show you, we're gonna go on to the next circuit is, we're gonna go up, down, up, and down. And that intensifies the workout just a little bit more, okay? Different ways that you can intensify your workout. You can make sure you check your watch your rest breaks in between each exercise, in between each circuit. You can obviously add weight, go heavier. You can increase the time that you're doing the exercises. So different ways that you can intensify the workout without having to go heavier weight all the time, okay? So first exercise we're gonna do for the next circuit is we're gonna go some dumbbell, some sumo, pulse squats. So holding the dumbbells, we're either gonna hold them here, both of them, or up on our shoulders. Our feet are gonna be nice and wide, toes are gonna be pointed out. We're gonna drop down, back is straight, and we're just gonna go halfway up and all the way down. Halfway up and all the way down. Again, making sure our knees follow the toes as much as possible. All the way down, halfway up. For 30 seconds. So here we go, ready? 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Keeping our back nice and straight. Wing. Good. These will burn, these will burn. Not just here, here, but also on that inside. Good, guys, good. Oh. Nice, nice. 7 seconds. Good, keep your back straight, keep your abs tight. Good. A little lower, a little little lower right there. And time. Good. Set them down off to the side. We're going to go with some half push-up holds. So we're going to go into push-up position with our hands wider than our chest. And we're going to drop down halfway, and we're going to hold for 30 seconds. Okay? I want to make sure that your hands are out wider than your shoulders. Not under your shoulders, wider than your shoulders. So here we go. Push-up position. And again, on your knees or on your toes, either one doesn't matter. And halfway down, and hold. There we go. Nice, guys, nice. Nice. Breathe. Want to make sure we breathe. We don't want to hold our breath. In through the nose and out through the mouth. Hang in there, guys. Halfway there. Hold it. Hold it. 7 seconds. Hang in there. A little shaking. It's all right. Hold it. 3 seconds. Hold it. And time. Awesome job. Back on your feet. Good job. Shake it out, shake it out, shake it out. We go back to some lower body now. So we're going to grab our dumbbells. Hold down by our side. We're going to put our right leg to the back and our left leg in front. And we're going to do some more pulses. So we're going to drop it all the way down, halfway up. All the way down, halfway up. Okay, 30 seconds. Here we go. Ready? 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Nice. And again, their backs are nice and straight. They're looking forward. Their chest is up. You can read their shirts. Matter of fact, you can read Gina's Core Evolution shirt, tank top that she has. Nice, guys. And again, if you have any questions, please message us. Let us know. We'll get back to you guys. Whether it's about the workout, anything about the gym, let us know. And time, good. Shake it out a little bit. We're going to do the other leg now. All right, here we go. In 3, 2, 1, and down. Go. All right, so they're going almost all the way down and halfway up. Yeah, right there, right there. Nice. Good. Hang in there. And if we have to, set the weights down and keep going. So they set the weights down, they're gonna keep going. The trick is just not to stop. Awesome, guys. 7 seconds, hang in there, come on. Hang in there. And time. Okay, last exercise, we do a little cardio. And we're gonna do some jumping jacks. So 30 seconds of jumping jacks. Ready, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Good. Hands are all the way up. Awesome. And they're breathing. Control that breathing. In through your nose, out through your mouth. Awesome. Good job, guys. And halfway there. So I have my timer, making sure that this, we, you know, we keep to the time. You have your phone, whatever, use that. Whatever you have to do, I think that's the most important thing when it comes to home workouts is that we set a timer and we follow. We set the time we want to do each exercise and the break and time. Good job, guys. We're going to get a 1 minute break for this one. But set your time for your rest, set your time in between your sets and follow it. Sometimes when we go to our regular gym or whether it's here or we're with a trainer sometimes, a big box gym, and we do our exercise, then we get on our phone, right? Or we start talking to somebody. And then we lose the intensity of the workout. When we're doing something like this at home, very easy, a lot of distractions that we can lose that intensity. So if we're able to keep with our timer, stick to it, we're able to keep that intensity level up and be able to get done with the workout too a lot faster. All right, so we got about 30 seconds left on your break. Renegade rows with a push-up. So Gallo's gonna demonstrate it one way, Gina's gonna demonstrate it the other way. Gallo's gonna keep his hands on the dumbbell the whole time. He's gonna do a push-up and then a roll with the right arm, roll with the left arm, and then back down to a push-up and repeat. Gina's gonna keep her hands on the floor, do the push-up on her knees, come back up, grab one dumbbell, row it, set it down, grab the other dumbbell, row it, set it down, and then back to the push-up. So Gallo's gonna do them with the dumbbells the entire time. Gina's gonna have her hands off with them for half the time. All right, we'll go 30 seconds. And ready, here we go, 3, 2, 1, let's go. So she's gonna grab one dumbbell, row it, then the other dumbbell, row it, and then back down. Gallo's got his hands on the dumbbells the entire time. So Gallo's feet are a little bit wider, which is fine. Gina's here together, she could open them up if she wanted to, but more importantly, their backs are nice and flat, even when they're doing the rows. Very little movement with the hips, and that's exactly what we want. We don't want to rotate those hips too much. 5 seconds. and time on your feet. Good job, guys. We're bringing those dumbbells up. We're going with our thrusters. Thrusters. So down and press them up. All right, 30 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Let's go.
All right. Okay.
Inhale on the way down and exhale as we push them up. Use the power of our legs to get those dumbbells up. Good. Nice, guys. Nice. Nice drop. Awesome. Still maintaining wherever those toes go, that's where our knees follow. 5 seconds. Good, good. Hang in there. And time. Okay, so let's put them down. We're going to do some diamond push-ups. Work in the back of the arm. We get a lot of talk here, people asking, what can I do for the back of the arms? For our triceps, diamond push-ups, one of the best things that you can do. So, with your diamond push-ups, close grip push-ups. If you cannot form a diamond with your hands here, you can always have them in closer, maybe not touching, but close, as long as they're within our shoulders. We don't want to have them out wider than our shoulders. We want to have them within our shoulders here and under our chest. That's the other thing. I see a lot of people doing diamond push-ups with their hands up here. Bring them down here into the chest. So here we go. Diamond push-up, 30 seconds. Again, on your toes or on your knees, either one, as long as the back is flat. 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Nice, guys. Good. Inhale on the way down, exhale on the way up. Gala's got his hands together in that diamond shape. She's gonna draw a little bit space apart, but they're still within her shoulders inside, and that's exactly what we're looking for. And her back is still nice and straight. 10 seconds. Good. Nice, guys. And time. Okay, we're gonna stay down there on the floor. We're gonna go from low plank to high plank. Okay, so we're doing the low plank position. Our elbows are under our shoulders, forearms are flat. We're gonna push ourselves up into a high plank or push-up position and then back down to the floor. Okay, important. Where my elbows are, my hands replace my elbows. And when we go back down, my elbows replace my hands. So here we go, 30 seconds, low plank to high plank. In 3, 2, 1, let's go. Back down, awesome, awesome. Good, guys. Nice. Yeah. And if you have to modify this, you can do it on your knees also. And that'll help out, make it a little bit easier for you. 5 seconds. And time. Okay, last one, a little bit of cardio now. We're gonna do some jump squats, finish off. 30 seconds of jump squats, remember? Still, wherever those knees go, or wherever the toes go, that's where the knees go. 30 seconds, 3, 2, 1, and go. So nice and easy. As long as we get those toes up off the floor, using our arms, breathing, we're good. Doesn't have to be a super high jump, we just wanna keep going. 20 seconds. Good. Nice, guys, awesome. 10 seconds. Good. Breathe, breathe, breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth. And time. All right, I'm gonna give them 1 minute break. We're gonna do a couple of ab exercises and we're gonna finish off. Again, we're not doing the entire workout. What we're basically trying to show you guys is 3 different circuits that you can do at home with very little weight, very little equipment. And then you can modify yourself and you can do each circuit 2 or 3 or 4 times, whatever your time limit is, and then move on to the next circuit. Or you know, you can do them all for like, say the first 4 exercises, you can do them all and do yourself like an AMRAP, as many rounds as possible for 10 minutes. You set a timer for 10 minutes and you set a number for each exercise and you go through as many times as you can. Whatever you want to do to modify it, the main thing that we're trying to show you here is the good form, the technique that you should be doing it with, and then also some modifications that you can, if you need to, that you can use at home, okay? So we're gonna do some ab exercises really quick to finish off. We'll do some Russian twists first off, and we're gonna hold the dumbbells. So we're gonna do some Russian twists with the dumbbells. Okay. So our knees are gonna be bent. We're gonna pick our heels up off the floor. Dumbbells at our chest right here, we're gonna turn side to side. So 30 seconds in 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Whatever's comfortable way to hold the dumbbell, medicine ball, whatever you want is fine. What I look for when we do our Russian twist here is that our shoulders, our head, our chin, our chest, everything turns. We're not just doing this. Everything rotates side to side. They have their feet up, which is great. If you need to, you can set your heels down and keep going. And also, we never cross our ankles over here. Our feet are always together, okay? 5 seconds, keep going. Good. and time. Okay, so instead of the dumbbells off the side, we are gonna use one though, but we're gonna both turn sideways. So either way, it doesn't matter. Turn sideways. Keep one dumbbell with you. Okay, we're gonna be on our back, so watch your head. And our legs are gonna be up 90 degrees. We're gonna have the dumbbell over our face, arms out straight. We're just gonna reach up, we're gonna control our lower body so this doesn't move. The dumbbell we're gonna push up to the ceiling, head and shoulders off the floor, and then back down. So here we go, 30 seconds. Ready, 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Just like that, nice and easy. Control that lower body. Good. Keep the dumbbell right there, up, there. Keep those dumbbells over the face as much as you can. 20 seconds. Good. Nice, guys. Again, our feet, 90 degrees here, knees over the hips. Nice and tight right there. 7 seconds. Awesome, guys. And time. All right, guys. On your feet, like I always say, on your feet. Again, guys, there's 3 different circuits that you can do at home with very little equipment. If you don't have a dumbbell and you can improvise with something else that you have, great. If you have to do it with just body weight, you can do it with just body weight. If you have any questions regarding any of the exercises, the workouts, classes here, personal training, please message us, let us know, we'll get back to you. Once all of this temporary closure is shut down, we are gonna have some specials when it comes to personal training and classes. So if you have any questions, please message us. We'll get back to you as soon as we can, all right? Hope you guys have a good workout. Remember, be safe, guys. Make sure you follow the technique. Do your best you can. Give it all that you got. Have a great night, guys. Talk to you guys later.